Good evening, everyone, and congratulations to the World IP Forum team for successfully organizing the conference. I'm Vidushi Bharadwaj, patent attorney at LS Dawar & Company, which is one of the most trusted IP firms in India since 1932. Today, I will be discussing the proposal to implement the utility patent model to encourage the emerging innovation culture in India. So, while discussing, I will be taking up all these agendas. Coming to the first one, which is branding a country with its innovation. Just as an example, whenever we are talking about Japan, the first thing that comes to our mind is speedy trains or bullet trains. Similarly, about USA, we think of computing, softwares, and cars about Germany. So here we can see that these nations have really worked hard in certain fields of technology, and that is their specialty now. So we can clearly say that innovation drives technology, and technology in turn drives a nation. And these are so beautiful examples of this. Talking about India, we can see that India as a nation has a history of glorious and innovative past. In our mythology, we can see some examples. In our mythology, we have a knowledge bank of scientific thoughts related to medical sciences, genetic advancements, and even flying machines. So we can see we have a history of glorious and innovative past. Then, in order to support and in order to maintain that innovation culture, the government of India has been taking several initiatives. These are few of the examples like Startup India, Make in India, Skill India, Venture Capital Scheme, Support for International Patent Protection. An example of Make in India, like with this initiative, the government has accelerated an initiative of encouraging global industries to use our natural resources and develop their manufacturing units in India. Further, it has been backed up by a lot of skilled labor here and easy availability of abundant skilled labors and easy clearances of quick environment and legislative provisions. So, with this, we can see that there is a rise in the culture of innovation and technical startups here. Because so much of support has been provided by the government to these startups, so there is a culture of innovation and technical startups. These are few of the figures we can see that more than 50,000 startups have been coming up every year from 2018 till now. And out of which one-fifth are technology-led startups. So on an average, we can say that 2 to 3 startups are coming up every day in India. So we can say that with Make in India, we started up with Make in India, and eventually we are shifting towards Invent in India. This is what India's approach towards innovation right now. Now, the question we need to decide is, are these Indian startups? Because we can see the Indian market is flooding. It is being flooded with Indian startups. But are these Indian startups, which are although backed by several government schemes, awareness programs, etc., but are these Indian startups really ready to compete with the tech giants in the market? We need to decide this. So, in order to get the answer, in order to come to the answer, I would just like to take help of a story of a high utility product. So we see that this is actually a utility patent which has been granted in one of the nations. This is just an example. We see that there is a hanger, and some modifications have been made to the conventional hanger structure. These modifications have several advantages which it will serve. So a startup has come up with such a product. This product seems to be useful and it will serve the society. But now, can we see that these grassroots innovations, what is the status of these grassroots innovations in India? Because these are incremental innovations and they are very worthy. They are actually worthy. It will be of use. But these innovations may meet the novelty test. Now, we have these startups. They are already aware of the IP regime. They are already aware that in order to sustain, they have to take help of IP protection. So a smart move would be to apply for patent protection. But once they will go for such filing or for such protection, after examination, it will be found that although it will meet the novelty test, but it may not meet the inventive step test in view of the patent laws we have. So it might not meet the inventive step test. So these technically less complex products, they have the capability, they have the potential to uplift these SME sectors. The company, the startup which will be bringing this technology in the market, once they start marketing it, it will add to their wealth, it will add to their worth. The product will have a potential, but our patent system will not welcome it because it will not qualify the patentability test. So what will happen? It will be of not much use to the startup. Once it will enter the market, then the competitors will get similar product in the market, and within a span of few days, I would say a few days, their value will be diminished. So, having discussed this problem in view of the present scenario in India, now we want to come to some strategies and suggestions. So the first question now is, should we leave all these innovations? Should we leave all these incremental innovations coming up in India? Should we leave them unprotected? But that is not a smart move. That will not be a good move. The next question is, can we have an alternative means of protection for these high utility innovations? They might not be patentable. They might not qualify all the tests of patentability, but still they have high utility. And it will be a solution for the growth of MSEs and startups. It will drive them very fast. So if we do not want to leave them unprotected, should we have some alternative means of protection? So we see that a few provisions that in Paris Convention, the convention recognizes utility models as an object of industrial property together with patents. So with patents, it says that there is one more means of protection of such high utility models and which is such high utility products and which is utility models. TRIPS also, although it requires all the countries to maintain minimum substantive standards for all the intellectual property regimes, but regarding this second tier patent system, which is utility model, although it discusses this, but it leaves on all the member countries to formulate it for themselves, and it is not at all obligatory or it is not at all mandatory for the nations to implement these provisions. But yes, we can draw that at least we have some suggestions in all these statutes. So can this alternate means of protection, can this be helpful in India? That we need to know. So if we come to India, in a resource constrained economy like India, so these minor technical inventions, they frugally use local resources in a sustainable manner, and they need to be encouraged by providing a legal framework for their protection and commercial exploitation. This is what the commercial studies says that in India, these minor inventions, they need to be protected. By what means they are being protected, that will be discussed later. But yes, the study says that we need to protect these inventions in a country like India with such an economy. So we see that because all these products, they will mainly come from SME sectors. It will mainly come from SMEs. So protection will only be useful and relevant if it is provided through a legal framework. So we need to have a legal framework for protection of these technical inventions, these minor inventions, or rather incremental inventions. So we need to have certain legal framework. We have seen how these inventions are, why they are not qualifying the patentability test, and we have seen that these inventions are coming up, so many inventions, like all these inventions, they are coming up so rapidly in India because of the innovation trend, because of the startup trend we are having right now. We have also seen that all these need to be protected a lot in order to uplift the economy, and it suits the Indian scenario that we have to protect it. Now, for the protection, we have seen because it is not coming from tech giants, it is coming from SMEs. So in order to implement it in a better manner, we need to have some legal framework that we have found out. Now, for legal framework, we just have a suggestion that few statutes say that utility model is one of the means of protection which can protect such minor inventions. But can this be beneficial to India? That we need to know. Now, we need to know what utility models actually are. So utility models are a framework for providing limited protection to those innovations which may not meet the standards of the Patents Act and yet are commercially exploitable and socially relevant. So we see these are the standards, or these are the essentials for a product to qualify as a utility model. And the example we discussed earlier, the example of this product. So this will qualify as a utility patent. Now, we can see that there are several nations, several countries, they already have such protection framework. And it is known by different names in different nations. Like we can see that it is for innovation patents in Australia, short-term patents in Belgium, Ireland, and Netherlands, utility certificates in France, simple patents in Indonesia, utility solutions in Vietnam, and utility innovations in Malaysia. More than half of the nations, they have already recognized this concept and they are following this. These nations include superpower nations. These include developed nations, developing nations, and underdeveloped nations also. So we, being a developing nation, we need to know that whether it will be suitable for such an economy of a developing nation like us. Although it has been implemented by almost every type of country. What are the benefits? First, we need to know that what utility model is that we have discussed, and what are its effects or benefits. It will incentivize faster disclosure because the process of registration is easy, comparatively faster, cheaper than patents usually, as we see it has been implemented in other nations with all these benefits. So it incentivizes faster disclosure. It triggers innovations by availability of disclosed information to improvisers of derivative products. So it's like improvising over the already available technology. So it triggers innovations, yes. Then, it also triggers innovation because of the comparatively lower level of R&D required for this. So this is a driving force for small players in the market, that they can quickly come up with more and more products with less resources, less time, and less expenditure. So we see that generation of a pool of incremental innovations may trigger new innovations that we have discussed. Then it hasten market entry for new products by enabling migration from the utility model system to the patent system. Also, the role of small innovators and local artisans, because we are talking about grassroots inventions also. So these small innovators and local artisans, initially, they did not find their significant role in the market. They just used to come up with few new products, used to sell them, and only till their product has a specific value. They did not have any significant role till now. But if we implement this utility model, these small innovators, these local artisans, so their role can be enlarged in economic development. It may also help them to stay in business. Just like big companies, they file for patents, they maintain their patent portfolio, and they do business. So just like them, on a lower level or on a smaller scale, these local artisans, small innovators, I would like to mention that India has a rich culture of small innovators and local artisans. The local art, or we say these grassroots inventions in India, there is a lot of scope of these innovations. So if all these are backed up, or all these, they have a sense of confidence, they have a sense of involvement in the economic development, it will help them stay in the business. And they won't be threatened by new and sophisticated technologies. Because we see, if a product is coming up in the market through local artisans, the product will be good. The product will initially, it will create a boom in the market. But what happens after some time, a big tech giant, they come up with a similar product with lower cost. And that lower cost is due to less manufacturing cost because of their infrastructure, obviously. Infrastructure and other resources, there will be less manufacturing cost to them, and so less final cost. So at that time, these local artisans, they are driven away from the market by these sophisticated technologies. So if initially they are already provided protection, then they won't be threatened by these new technologies, by these sophisticated technologies for the limited period, and about the rights they are granted under these utility models. So they will have this sense that yes, they are also driving the economy of the nation. These are the benefits. But yes, while implementing this, first, we actually need to know that is it feasible for India? Because there is no standard model which has been implemented by all the nations. The nations, they have differentiated models which suits their economy and their society. Like there is a different model in Japan, there is a different model in China. So depending on their local needs, they have somehow amended the provisions of the utility model. So first, because as we have discussed, India needs the model specifically for its informal sector. So first we need to analyze the economy of informal sector, and then only we can implement it. Also, few points we need to know before implementing this. And these include that if any alternative regime, suppose we are proposing this utility model. So in any such alternating regime, it should cater specifically to the incremental and novel innovations of informal sector, because we are already talking about informal sector. So in that case, it is important to first understand the informal economy and then innovation in the informal economy. What is the purpose of innovation in the informal economy in this country? Because they are, as we see, they are centered on the communities and clusters and not individual innovators. So if we imply this utility model here, that will be centered around the innovator, around the individual. So is that going to suffice the purpose? Is that going to fulfill the purpose that we need such model for? Because we need such model to uplift the community. So we first need to analyze if we give some rights to the innovator, to the individual, is that going to uplift the society or not? So that has to be taken care of. Then we have seen that in few countries, they have implemented the model in such a way that protection is granted to specific and to certain identified fields of technology. For example, in India, we can say that it will apply on mechanical technology or on chemical technology, just for an example, or electronics. So we need to first identify the market, the after effects, prospective effects of this, and then we can have this implemented in certain identified fields based on the economy, based on the market structure. So these all points have to be taken care of. Also, we see that in China, what is done, that it extends, they take the model and extend it to patent demand, that they both cannot be taken at the same time. Patent and utility model, they cannot be taken at the same time. Such references can also be drawn, and we can have a model which best suits our nation. So all these pros and cons of utility models need to be analyzed critically, like we have analyzed the market structure, the impact on individuals versus the impact on the community or clusters, the need of this model to this nation, to particular community, to a particular field. So we need to analyze all these. If the model is implemented with necessary safeguards and has the possibility of doing wonders for the individual innovators working outside the boundaries of formal sectors, so we are talking about informal sector, then it is worth taking the risk, as it could foster inclusive growth. Because this second tier patent system, we have seen some examples where it has done wonders, but we have also seen examples where it has drastically failed. Few countries, they have implemented it at the same time with good provisions which best suited their economy. Like Japan, we can see that after the Second World War, although they had the provision before the Second World War also, but after the Second World War, it got so much attention and so much support. So we see that it gradually took a flight and it flourished the market. It led to a boom in the market. So it actually supported the economy in Japan a lot, this utility model provision, because it was a good timing and the provision best suited to their system. This is how we need to analyze and we need to put forward the product, the model in India. Several proposals have been made to implement the model. However, we cannot take a side that yes, this can be implemented or this cannot be implemented, because the best word to say would be this can be implemented with best suited provisions. So, moving ahead, India could think towards developing a model which can cater to the needs of the informal sector in the best manner. So, hoping that soon we come up with such a model, because we have already so many discussions, so many debates going on, that whether this model will be good to India, it will support Indian economy or not. So with these discussions, we are hoping to have a better change, a good change in the Indian system, and that will be very helpful to the Indian economy. So this is what I had to mention in the discussion. I hope that the information was in order and the discussion was a few. So if there are any queries or questions, we are open for that. You may contact us. Our contact details are shared here. Thank you.